Today, we'll solve an airplane problem as an example of related race. If you remember four things, you can easily solve related race problems. First, condition. Find out what condition is given in the problem. Second, question. Identify what the problem is asking for. Third, relation. Try to relate the variables given in the condition and question. Lastly, differentiate the relation with respect to time. Now, let's apply this to solve a common related race problem. An airplane problem. Imagine there is an airplane that passes directly overhead, then flies horizontally away from observer with an altitude of 5,000 and airspeed 200 meters per second. At what rate is its angle of elevation to the observer changing at the instant when the angle of elevation is 60 degrees? The airplane is flying horizontally at an altitude of 5,000 meters, and let's call the horizontal distance x, and then the angle of elevation is theta. Let's find the first of the four components we learned earlier. The condition in the problem. Since the problem states that the airplane is moving at a speed of 200 meters per second, the distance traveled by the airplane x is changing over time, so we'll use the dx over dt as the condition, and let's set it equal to 200. Since x is increasing with respect to time in this problem, we'll simply use plus 200, but if the variable were decreasing with respect to time in another problem, don't forget to include the minus sign. The second thing we need to look for is the question. The question in this problem is asking for the rate of change of the angle of elevation, which is d theta over dt. We will later use this to find the value of d theta of dt when theta is equal to 60 degrees. Thirdly, let's try to find the relation that connects the x from the condition and the theta from the question. Looking at the left diagram, we see a right angle triangle where the opposite is 5,000 and the adjacent is x. Therefore, we can make the relation as tangent theta equals 5,000 over x. Now, we move on to the last step, which is the time differentiation of the relation. For those who find implicit differentiation difficult, I'll make a separate video explaining it in an easy-to-understand manner and upload it soon. We'll move the constant 5,000 to the left-hand side, which is not affected by the differentiation, and write 1 over x as x to the power of negative 1. Now, if we differentiate both sides with respect to time, the time derivative of tangent theta becomes secant squared theta times d theta over dt. Since we are not simply differentiating tangent theta with respect to theta, we must remember to multiply d theta over dt at the end. And let's not forget to multiply the right-hand side by negative x to the power of negative 2, and the time derivative of x, which is dx over dt. So the left side becomes the 1 over cosine squared theta multiplied by d theta over dt, and the right side becomes negative 5,000 over x squared multiplied by dx over dt, with the negative exponent changed to a positive 1. Remember the question we were asked earlier? It was about d theta over dt, right? Then why don't we multiply both sides by cosine squared theta to isolate d theta of dt? In the problem's condition, dx over dt was given as 200 meters per second. And in the question, theta was given as 60 degrees. But we also need to find what x is to find the answer. Let's use the formula we created in the relation. First, tangent 60 equals square root 3. And this value becomes 5,000 over x. Solving for x, we get x equals 5,000 over square root 3, and we'll use this later. Next, we know that cosine 60 is half, so we are now ready to find the value of d theta dt. Using the values we found, d theta dt becomes negative 5,000 times half to the power of 2 over 5,000 over square root 3 squared times 200. It looks complicated, so let's simplify it by writing the numerator as negative 5,000 over 4 times 200 and expanding the denominator's parentheses and squaring it. Then we remove the common factor of 5,000 from the numerator and denominator, and we write the expression as negative 200 over 4 in the numerator and 5,000 over 3 in the denominator. We then rewrite negative 200 over 4 as negative 50, and multiply the numerator and denominator by 3, which gives us negative 150 over 5,000. Removing the common factor of 50 from the numerator and denominator and dividing each by 5, we get the final answer of negative 3 over 100 radians per second. What do you think? Just like I emphasized earlier, by going through the steps of defining the condition, question, and relation, and then differentiating the relation with respect to time, we are able to easily find the answer to this problem. Since I've seen many students struggling with the related race problems, I have created these 4 steps to explain this process. If you have any questions or topics you'd like me to cover in future videos, please feel free to leave a comment. If you find this video helpful, please subscribe and like. Thanks for watching. I've been your math guardian, Alex.